Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BFU Gaming, and today we are back in Mercury Fallen, and I just realized we actually have one blue twin fin axe. We must have gotten that from one of the expeditions, but I don't even recall getting it. But that means that we have unlocked a couple of recipes here that we can actually research. So, fried fish, nice, let's unlock you. And well, we have plenty of points over here, so now we can also get fish and chips, and the only thing we need is research points, so that should be fine. We have fish chunks, yep, that we can make in food processor, just 25 research points, let's unlock you. Then we have sushi. We're gonna need green algae for that. We might as well just unlock it because we do have the points, right? But we can't really do anything yet. We need to find some green algae spore on an expedition so that we can start actually producing some green algae. There we go. That was that. I think that's everything we can do right now. For everything else, we kind of need to find more stuff on the surface. Then we have you, of course. I might as well actually unlock it because we don't really have anything else to spend a point on right now, and then we can build up new points for more stuff. Okay, so now that is sorted. Then if we go over here, well, I guess we do get some green algae from this though. Not that much, but we do get some. So we might be able to do some stuff anyway, but now we should be able to make some more foods. So if we say fried fish, craft if below, I don't know, we don't really have that many yet because we have to set up some aquariums and things. We only have like 34 that we have gotten from the trap here, but you know what, let's just set it to what, 100, and then we're gonna do the same thing over here. So we have two cooks that can be working on these things, right? So 100, apply, and then cave-in. Okay, I don't think anyone got hurt. That's just a little bit of sand. Okay, let's go back down here and go back in here, and then actually remove that. Then I think we can make the fish and chips. I think it requires the fried fish, if I remember correctly. Yes, and then cooked potatoes. So it actually uses some of the meals we already have to make this one. Far more filling than just a potato, but I assume making this is even more filling than having these and these separately. So we're gonna try and turn some of it into these, right? Well, we're also gonna just say 100 of those. Nice. And over here, add item order for fish and chips, craft if below, 100. And then of course we have the sushi. Okay, so we need fish chunks for that, and of course the green algae. So let's try and see if we can get eventually 100 of those, and then we are gonna add sushi here. Nope, let's say 100. I don't know how many we actually need, but right now we're doing okay with just making sure. It's not like we have to have 1,000, right? We just have to have more in storage than what they eat, and probably a little bit more. And every time we go below that limit, then they will start, or below that threshold, they'll start cooking more, right? So for the fish chunks, we're gonna have to go in here. We are making trap bait in here from potatoes, which is why we're growing extra potatoes now. Then we are making fish flakes, which take arrowhead fungus and cave worm. Okay, and now we can make fish chunks from the fish themselves. So you can see we're gonna need a lot of fish. We're already running out of them. But you know what? Let's just tell them to you. Well, let's say we're gonna have 50 of these. And what else can we do in here? How's the fish chunks? And that's the refined organic we can do. Yep, okay, that should be fine. How many cooks do we have? We have you, two, and three. We do have three, but it would be nice to have someone extra, right? So that when someone is sleeping, then we can still have three people working here. How are we doing on the clone over here? I'm so hoping we're gonna get someone that's a little bit smarter, because man, They are leveling up so slowly because many of them, even with equipment, it's like, you know, they have 4 in smart, so they level up so slowly in their skills. Like, see, you have 2, so even with this, you're still only gonna be at 4. Ugh, it's terrible. It is terrible. Let's see, you can get some shoes, and you can get this, and then they're gonna make some new equipment we can equip them with. Okay, so now that is sorted, then I think we're gonna turn you, I know it's almost ready to be, well, it's 70%, but you know what, we're gonna clear it, and then we are gonna add that we want to grow hemp here, because we don't have that much hemp, actually, or even bioplast. You can have 61, but look at that, we're out of hemp. I am thinking if I need to actually start more plots with that. We're growing a lot of potatoes over here, but we also kind of need them. So that's probably fine. Let's put you right there. And let's try and finish up the floor a little bit here. Figure out where we want to go with that. And then on the surface. Let's go on the surface for a second here, because we do have someone sitting around. Ooh, yep. Don't forget these guys. They do have 36 potatoes, but if I forget about them, they're just gonna starve out here, and we don't want that happening. What is going on here? Oh, it's just because they're failing at certain things, because their skills aren't that high. Okay, what did we have in here? Did we already investigate this? Has arrived at the entrance to a cave. But to send someone down. Alright, that was really, really low. So, you know what? Let's not do it. I think we're gonna say ignore. This will remove the PY, yes, because then I don't get confused by it. And then we're gonna take you. And let's just check what this one was. And let's see how we're doing on our beetle. Oh, did we finish our beetle miner? We did! We have our first beetle miner. Oh, we're gonna have to set up a... can we make a transport already? Yeah, we can. I haven't made any of those yet. We're definitely gonna need this. A basic resource transport vehicle that can be assigned to buildings for automatic resource retrieval. But for that, we need... Okay, we need steel. We don't really have enough of that either. But we're gonna set it to construct, because we definitely need one of these. And then we're gonna take our little beetle miner here. Let's see what kind of equipment we have. I do want to set up a mining station. But until I have a research transport that can actually bring things back to base from that mining station, we're just gonna try and do this. Or just mine with the beetle miner, and then we have to bring it back and forth. So we can move it faster. Mining time minus 10. And minus time... Okay, let's just use this one. And also let's move fast. There we go. And then... Let's see, while they are getting equipment for them, let's see what this one was, because I have forgotten. Here we go. That was another cave. Is that the same deal? Yeah, 25% from health, 0 from stress, 0% from athletics. It's just too low for me to really want to do it, so let's leave you. And then we are going to take you... And we are gonna bring you over here. Hopefully they have enough food for it, because I want to see if we can get... I don't know if this is the one. Well, we're gonna get some bio samples from this, I think. And then I don't know if this is where we can get some algae spores, potentially. And then we also... Sorry, I have a kitty that is very chatty in the background. I don't know if you guys can hear him. It is not distracting at all. Then we have an extra doge, or DOGE. And Max, can you be quiet a little bit? Oh, so whiny. Sorry, guys. Since I want to turn this into a radar tower, we're just going to embark it. I don't really want to waste any kind of equipment on it. So let's embark you. And then you, I think we're going to send over here. Because I want to set up another radar. Oh, that's because you got to here with auto exploration. No, you have equipment, so let's just leave you to do that. But I was thinking about setting up a radar tower over here, potentially on this tile, because it gives us one blue meadow, which we also have up here. It also lets us have access to some fungal forest, the shadow forest over here, And, or maybe it should be this one instead. Actually, I think I want to set it up on this one. Because then we have this, we have this, we have Shadow Forest, Swamp, Fungal Forest, Rub Land, of course the Blue Meadow, Boreal Shrub, and Tendril Forest all around this. It's just one of each, but at least we have a chance to get whatever kind of PUI can be on that. And then maybe we'll set up another radar tower down here, maybe near some of these things or over here. So yeah, I think that's going to be the idea. So that was you, right? Just making sure it's the right one. And I want to send you to this one. There we go. You do that. And how are we doing? Did we make it? Over here? Oh, we did already. Wow. Oh, they haven't eaten that many potatoes. Well, they can get around a lot. So investigate. An almost solid wall of twisted vines and massive trees stands before the expedition team. After some nervous glances, the team finds an opening and enters the forest. It is dark and eerily silent. A faint glow radiates through the leaves ahead. Okay, go towards light. The darkness has given way to a wash of blue light that paints the aged trees. The source of the light is a grove of bioluminescent plants. The team takes a sample for further study. Okay, so we found some lumen bulbous seed seeds. Not really what I was hoping for. We got some biosamples and we got some lumen bulbous. Okay. So we got a little bit of that stuff. If we take a look at you, we still have, yeah, we still have plenty of room. So let's go and see what this is about. And how is my little, oh, it's going to take a little while before it gets down there, but that's fine. Then we have the miner here, and it has gotten its equipment now, so let's just send you out. And the main thing I think I want right now is rutile, so we can start making titanium. And for that, if we go in here and look at resources, then of course the more blue it is, the better. And for rutiles, it's always pretty low, the percentages. That's why there's no really like dark blue. These is just because they are unexplored. So I think some of the max is like this, 5.3%, 5.5. I think I've seen up to 6%. But it's not really, ooh, there is 6.9 over here. It's a bit far away, but that could potentially be something. Let's see, which one was it? Yeah, let's just send you over here. And let you do some mining. You could also do it up here. That is actually shorter. But eventually we're going to set up a resource transport that is just going to be going back and forth here. But right now we kind of have to do it manually. So we're going to have to see what we are going to do about that. How is the station coming along? Or the... Yeah, we need steel. Why are we not getting any steel? Steel, steel, steel. Let's see, we have 50 copper ingots, we have 22 iron ingots, we have 17 steel billets. We do have plenty mineral compound, we do have azurite, we do have hematite, we don't have that much hematite though. Which is for making iron and eventually steel, right? So I don't know, maybe it's because... What are you making? You're actually making steel. But it might be because we don't have that many engineers, so they can't really keep up. I have 4 machines, right, where the engineers are needed, and I think we have 5. Did we get a new person yet? Oh, here we go. Yeah, okay, so you... Oh, you are actually smart. Nice. You know what? You are definitely gonna let you be an engineer. And then when you're not doing that, what do I need you to be doing? I don't know. Well, you're gonna be pretty busy, so you're not really gonna be able to do much of anything. So I am kind of thinking, okay, let's let you be a technician and then you can hold some stuff. He's not gonna have much time to do much of anything, but I think we're gonna give him some new equipment. There we go. Awesome. So he's gonna be, oh, look at that. 777. That's like one of the best ones we have. Yeah. He's gonna be 999 instead. Oh, that is awesome. Okay, let's how many people do we have? We have 13, so we can handle another clone. Let's do that, and then we should probably make another one of these. So, what was my plan here? Or something like this, I think. Yep, so we need some flooring. Utility floor. Be like this. And, yep, this one. Now let's just put both of them. It looks like I already put, yeah, I already put power under here. Okay, but that is gonna let us have more people, more than the 15 we have room for, but we might as well get them because otherwise I'm just gonna mess up at some point and accept someone that we don't have anything for. Okay, it's really hard to do expeditions and be building in our facility at the same time because they, you have to keep an eye on these guys so they don't run out of food. It does go down really, really slow. They're still at 35, which is kind of interesting. So maybe something has changed since my last game because last time I actually lost some someone on expedition because they ran out of food, which is not good. Because I forgot about them, they were just sitting around, right? Okay, so we have a cave. Ooh, the cool air inside the cave is a welcome relief from the scorching heat outside. The smooth walls show clear signs of wind erosion. Further inside the cave, the team discovers primitive cave paintings. There are several depictions of strange fauna, as well as what appears to be a central focus on some sort of sun or eye. Okay, this is a different cave than the other one. Even deeper inside the cave, the team discovers a strange moss growing on the walls and ceiling. We should take a sample for further study. Okay, he only has 10%, and apparently the robot can't do anything. Oh, we need a botanist on our team for this. Oh, we're gonna have to do that, but we don't really have any high-level botanists. While we're here, let's do this, and then I think we're gonna send them home afterwards and then see if we can find a botanist. But I think they're all pretty low level at this point. So I'm not sure how much that's gonna help. A massive field of debris is scattered across the area. Whatever this used to be, it was certainly very large. After combing through the wreckage, it's determined that this was some sort of large passenger cruise ship. Additional clues indicate that the vessel struck an asteroid during its maiden voyage, but we got 80 tech fragments from it. Oh, that's nice. Okay, that's really nice. So we're gonna take you and we're just gonna send you back home and look into this thing with the botanist. So now I know I need someone with that skill as well. And let's go back to the normal view because now our little vehicle here made it and we're gonna turn you into a radar tower. There we go. So now we can start getting PYs in this area as well. Look at that. And we actually cover a lot of different types of biomes. Because certain PYs are dependent on you know, which kind of biome you are on. It seems like the cave, you get a lot of that around here. The first type of cave, the one we had here. And then the second type of cave was something over here. Oh, we have a new PY here. I think it was on the desert shrubland or something, or maybe it was on this one. So maybe we will get more of those caves over here. Oh, this must be the one because that's the one I couldn't explore, right? That's the one we needed the botanist for. Yeah. Okay, so now we have you. So desert seemed to be really good for, oh yeah, good for rutile, actually, desert land. Okay, well, you. I don't want a mining platform just yet. I just want you to mine. Oh, look at that. I like the little detail there. So now you are going to be mining, and you can see it's starting to fill up, and it's going to get us different things depending on what is on here. Okay, so How are we doing? Did you guys made it home? You're almost home. because then I don't have to worry about them while we're building, because we need to work on a biolab and see if we can actually do something with that one fish egg we have in the aquarium. So I want to get some aquariums built, but I don't want to lose any people because I forget about them. So here we go, and duck at facility. There we go. Okay, so no expeditions to worry about. How are we doing here? We still don't have enough. I'm kind of thinking... Oh, can I not cancel that? Maybe it's because they already put this, some stuff in there, or what? Huh. Vehicle assembly, because I was thinking about doing something else. But okay, then we are just going to leave it as that. So let's see how it's going down here. We are working on the next clone. And we have to set you. You are gonna make more potatoes. Cool. And what else do we have that's going on? We have this area over here. So for the fertilizer station, we need algae, and we need bio waste. So for raw organic, bio-waste. Let's make some bio-waste, and I think we're going to use the caveworm for it. I don't know how much we want to have of this. Let's say we just want 20 in storage. So apply, right? And then eventually, that was the bio-waste. Then we have the refined organic. We're going to want to make some plant nutrients, because then we can use it for our crop plots, and that's probably gonna help with how much we're getting, because we're really not keeping up with hemp, and it feels like it's strange that we have to have so many crop plots. So I want to see how much of a difference it's gonna be to have plant nutrients, right? Because this is part of the new stuff that I haven't tried yet in this update 24. So let's see, what if we just say 20 of those as well? We don't have a lot of algae. It's probably been used up by something else. Raw organic. Oh, it's under food, I think. I don't know why it's under food. And edible. Oh, because we... Oh, right, because we can use it for the sushi. But they haven't done any of that yet, because we don't really have enough fish to keep up with it. So right now we can make this instead. Let's just do that, and then someone should come and do it. And I think it's the botanists, potentially, that will be working here. Yeah, it's a botanist. So let's see. You have only level 4 in botanist. You have 3. You have 3. You have 2 C. So sending any of these off on expedition is not gonna be amazing. We're gonna have to hope we get a better clone. That's the word I was looking for. Because, well, they could also change you. Because you would definitely level up faster. A lot faster than the other. And you would probably catch up with these guys if I tell him to be a botanist. Because we already have a higher level engineer to send off on expeditions. And now he's at home working. So, you know what? Let's change you. You're going to be a botanist instead. That is going to be your focus. And then hopefully he will level up pretty fast. He already has a little bit of skill in it. Okay, cool. Let's see, do I have any new equipment? I think I've put something on pretty much everybody. Yep, let's do this. And of course you have to wait a second because we just used that. But you can get some new shoes. Then we just need a couple of caps and we're good. Until we get a new clone. Oh, so many things to keep track of. So if we go in here... Right now I set it to allowed items, but I actually don't think I want any of this in here. I want plant nutrients. Yeah, let's say that one is going to be for plant nutrients, and you are going to be for... All right, that's what I figured out last time. I can't actually put hemp in here, right? Or the algae in here, because it can't be stored in this. It to cancel. Okay, remove, apply, if they're going to empty it out. We're going to have to put a fridge or something in here, which again was the problem because we need a different type of flooring because we can't put a fridge on this. Let's see, where are you? That must be over here. Still can't do it. No, I have kind of mentioned it in the Discord, so I just had to check if we can do it now. But no, because I asked if we could please be allowed to also put it on the biolab floor. So we don't have to have a different type of floor just because we need the refrigerator in here. And otherwise, I have to store all my algae over here when I need it in here, right? Okay, so we need to make an aquarium. So I have to figure out where I want those. So we can see if we can actually do something in here now. Biolab floor. Looks like we have everything we need for it. This is actually, I think this is okay in size. So if the wall comes over here, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. So we should actually be okay with this room, that it doesn't collapse on us. We might want to have a door here, so let's just do this. And we're gonna bring you over here. And then we might bring the wall here, we'll see. I don't know if we actually need this much, but we also have xenobiotics we can get into, so let's mine you out. Mine some of this out. Need to have the walls built before we kind of remove everything. And then, oh, door. Let's put you there. And definitely want to have the flooring in here, but since we don't have an amazing amount of bioplastic, I don't feel like I really need to have more cloth, because the only thing we need the cloth for is beds. I could make more beds, but it doesn't seem like they ever fill these beds, so technically it looks like we have enough for all these people. And at this point, it doesn't really impact them. We have talked about it a little bit in the Discord for the game, that it might be cool that it impacted their happiness or something if they had their own bed. You know, that it would be a positive thing to have their own bed and have, instead of having to share it. But right now, it doesn't really do anything. Craft if below 150. So I have set it pretty high. We just don't have enough. Okay, do I have any? If I go in here and say this. Oh, we do. So if I just put that there. Do they just use one every now and then? Okay, so plant nutrients waiting for botanists to apply fertilizer. Can we store that over here? Is that a thing? Raw food, seeds of course, and raw organic. No, we can store bio waste, but not that. Would be kind of handy if you could store the fertilizer over here instead of having them to go somewhere else. Well, I could put a storage, I guess. But okay, I guess we are gonna do this for all of them. And then whenever they can, they are just gonna add some fertilizer. And I think we're gonna do it for the hemp because we keep. Okay, they have definitely used some of it now. Because we went down from 4 to 2. And then eventually you might also add it over here, but I think we're okay on potatoes at the moment, so that should be fine. Oh, there we go. Yeah, nice. Look at that. Have walls up. So let's mine you out. Let's mine these out for now. And then we are gonna need our aquariums. So do I want you over here? Let's see, that's 4. Could have one there, could have one here. Or do I want them more like out in the room? That might be kind of cool. Kind of having them here somewhere. I don't know how many we're gonna want of them. But technically we could have one there and one here. And maybe one there and another one there, depending on how many we want. Yep. Okay, so biolab. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that should be kind of the middle. And then like this, right? And then they stand here. And I would stand here, and then we could have another one here. But maybe have two kind of standing back to back. And then here. So eventually we could have four of them. That could be a plan. Okay. So aquarium. You gonna go right there. Nice. Can we do the xenobiotic yet? Did I? Let's see. Doesn't look like it. And let's have a look in here. Ooh, we haven't actually researched that yet. So, just needed 750. Because we do have some plant seeds that we have found. So maybe we can use those in here now. So let's research this. And do we have anything new here? No, not yet. Okay, and... ooh, aeroponics farm, but what do I need here? Ooh, I need, so we need to go and get some more biosamples before we can actually plant anything in here. Okay, fair enough, fair enough. Yep, so what do we need for you? I have 100. For more power storage, yeah, we have 100 there, and then we're gonna need another 100 here, so we need another 80. Cool, cool, cool. Yep, okay. And you, well, the floor is actually the highest priority, but I think that's what they're prioritizing at the moment, maybe. They already built it. Yep, so high priority. We just have to wait for the bioplastic again. Oh, that is really one that we are struggling with. But of course, it's also used for the flooring. Okay, maybe we need to have some more hemp growing. Do I need anything else in here? How are we doing on... iron is always the problem. Yeah. Okay, let's take a look here and see. Ooh, we have one. We have one. No. Oh, I did manage to cancel it then. Okay, so... might still be a good idea to make this, but we have enough for it now, so they should just start building it, so that's a good thing. And you, how are you doing? You are almost full. Man, it takes a while. And you even have a plus 25 to mining. But, okay. How many did you get? And look at that, we only got 8. Rutile never gives you that much. Man, and sand and mineral compound, but we're almost... full, so let's just let it fill it up, and then we're gonna bring it back home. There we go. Okay, so now you're full. We're gonna bring you over here so you can drop it off, and then we might actually just set it up and let the resource transport going back and forth. The only thing is, if I set it up, then I might not have enough to get another beetle miner, and I don't want to risk running out of resources. And we are kind of getting a little low on that. So let's look at the mining, actually, because I think... let's do deep mining. There's a little bit there we can do. But I don't think my deep miner is doing anything anymore. I think we have kind of... it has mined out everything there is to mine out. So let's just take a little round around and see what we can get. Some stuff over here that is open and available. We should definitely mine that out. Let's get this. And get this and this, and then we have a little canister. Ooh, one potato. Wow, that was an amazing haul, guys. An amazing haul. Here we go. Nice. And we have another one right there. Oh, that was better. That was better. We even got a little bit of rutile, so that was nice. Thank you. I think there's been a cave-in right here. I'm not sure I want to mine that out, though. Because then we might get another cave-in on top of it, right? Let's try and mine out some of all the stone here. Might give us some more mineral compound. Let's mine out that area. And let's try and mine this out. This. And we have a little bit there. Back to this one. And okay, let's make a little pathway through there. Get you. This. See what's here. Kind of just mine a little bit to there. Then we have you. Trying to get as much as possible. Let's see what's here. And let's try and mine through there a little bit. Got you. Got you. And there's a bunch of stone there. Might as well keep them busy, right? So, a little bit, and there's a little bit. And get this. See what's in here, if there's anything of value to come for. And let's get the stone over there. I know there's other little parts of stone here and there, but I kind of just want to open it up a little bit and see if there's something. We have some walls we could technically deconstruct. Take this one. And maybe this. Because we do have some supports around it, right? So, from the stone or the sand, or dirt actually. Get some of this. There's a bit there. Not that we really need mineral compound, we have quite a lot of it actually. I have like 6,000, so I think we're good on that. More things like metals that we're struggling a little bit with. Whew. Okay, how are we doing here? Awesome, and of course I forgot the power and everything. Let's just see what we can do here. Ooh, blue twin fin eggs. I don't know if we have to find more of this above the ground or if we can get new eggs from the aquarium itself. I guess we're gonna have to find out, right? And then we are gonna have to get some water in here. If we bring you across like this and kind of bring it down here and like this, and let's just bring it here. There we go. Nice. And if you get time, little miner, then you can get this as well. Okay. That was the water. Then we also need power. So let's bring you across. Do the same thing. There we go. Cool. So we have our first aquarium. Let's see how that goes. And let's let them build up some resources in the meantime. So I don't really want to put in... Well, I have 20 bioplastic. What is the other stuff we need if I want another one? We need steel. We need glass. That shouldn't technically be a problem. Well, the steel might end up being it. That's why I don't really... Because we're almost out of... We only have 25 iron ingots, right? So... Take a look at steel billet. Yeah, takes hematite. Okay, let's go up here. Let's see, what do we have? Did we have any new? Yeah, we have some PYs down here. And how is my little miner? You are here. So take you and drop off. And of course, that is gonna be arriving at these. And then someone is going to come and empty them out. I think we should maybe start working on some more storages here, because as we get into mining some more, we're going to fill this out like crazy. Let's do this. And have one over here. For now, that should help. Yeah. I was thinking about putting another ore refinery in here. Someone to work at. Actually, it only takes structure resin, so in itself, it's not really a problem. I want you all the way over here. Oh. Yeah, let's just do that. And eventually, you can put some more storages in there. you a phone, but you're kind of destroying everything, right? Did I put all these to high? No. High priority. And high. And high. Awesome. What about you? Well, you're kind of destroying all this equipment, but it might be a good idea to set it to high because otherwise it's going to be stored out here. What else would you? You are set to high. Awesome. Mm-hmm. Hey, there we go. Now we just need some water. And then this should start working. So let's see. Did I get another new? Yep. Okay. You. Oh, look at that. They are so poor. They are so bad. I don't know if it has changed or I'm just having really bad luck, but it might have been changed so they generally have a lower chance of getting high skills. But man, ugh. You are just not very good. What do I want to use you for? You're gonna level up really, really slowly, but you know what? Let's just have you be a botanist because they're gonna be busy. And then you can do. I don't really need a miner, really. So maybe you can help with some cooking. And when you're not doing that, you can do some hauling. Let's make sure you're a little bit smarter, stronger, and faster. Not that it's gonna help much. Ugh. Okay, let's grow another one. We can now have 25 people. Awesome. And let's see, that just takes some structure resin. So you know what, let's just kind of fill in the floor here a bit. And maybe all the way to here. We can have you, we have you. I think it's facing that way out. Right, so we can have two, then we can have two here. Then we could have... maybe we'll put the... Well, it depends on where we put the wall over here. But have you facing that way, you facing that way. Two more, but then we'll have to have the wall over here. That's fine. Yep. Okay, so... Now you are done. Can we find some iron? Actually, 77% from this, it does. What about the one you're on? Well, it might be fine. If we just say mine, let's see what you're gonna get. Inventory. There we go. Yeah, let's just get some iron in there because that's actually the main thing we're struggling for. We could use some titanium, yes, but if we run out of iron, then we're gonna have a big problem. So, resource transport is almost done. And I have gone completely over time, guys, because I got so distracted. So this is a little bit of a longer episode, but that's how it goes. Anyway, we got into this, so we're gonna see how it's going with that next time. So thank you for watching, guys, and as always, do take care and happy gaming.